Hey YouTube, welcome to my first YouTube makeup video. Today we're just gonna be starting with a simple makeup look. So first I'm just moisturizing my face with some Aveeno lotion. Then we're gonna start off with our eyebrows. We're gonna be using the Anastasia Dip Brow Pomade, and the color that I was using was in granite. And first we're gonna start off with not the beginning of the eyebrow, but close to the beginning of the eyebrow. You're gonna just shade that in, but you don't want it to be too harsh, which is why you're not starting exactly at the beginning. You're gonna just lightly shade in that beginning part, and then you're just gonna basically trace the shape of your eyebrow and fill in lightly. As you can see, I'm using the spoolie side of the brush to blend out those harsh parts. And again, I'm doing the same thing on the other side of my eyebrow. I usually like to start from the arch of my eyebrow and then go down and then do the front part. I don't know, that's just me. I'm just fixing some errors. Next I'll be using a flat brush, and I'm gonna be cleaning up my eyebrows with the LA Girl Pro Concealer in color Almond. For this, I like to start, as you can see, I like to start on the corner of my eyebrow and then I go to the front. I don't know why, that's just what I like to do, that's what works for me. You're gonna see later in the video that I actually use a different shade of concealer on my top portion of my eyebrows, just so it could give like that highlighted look on my eyebrows under my eyes, and it could just look more natural. I'm sorry y'all, it's so much rain outside, but I'm using a blending brush right now to just blend out my concealer. This shouldn't be too hard, and then if you do mess up your eyebrows, it's really like no way to mess it up to where you have to take off everything, because if you put too much dip brow, just clean it up with concealer. If you put too much concealer, just clean it up with dip brow. It's really simple. And as you can see, I'm using actually my foundation. I'm using the NARS Pure Radiant Tinted Moisturizer in the color Santiago. That's just gonna help with my eyebrows like come out with a more natural look. And this foundation smells really good, but you don't even have to use it as a foundation. Clearly, only I'm using it as a as a concealer too. And right now, as you can see, I like to do the front of my eyebrow first with the concealer and just connect each eyebrow so that they're like lined up together. And I'm just doing what I'm doing with the bottom of my eyebrow. Like I said, if you mess up with concealer, use the dip brow. If you mess up with the dip brow, use the concealer. And then I'm just gonna be blending that in with my blending brush. I don't know why I did that thing. These are my lashes that I will be using. Hold on, about to come up. These are my lashes that I'm using. I don't know why there's not a name on it, but this is my lash brand. I believe, I don't know why there was nothing in there. But I believe the, yes, that's the right one. I believe the name is Alani. These lashes are really good. And if you know me, you know I love lashes. So you gotta know that I took the time to make sure these lashes are bomb. So if you guys wanna buy, you guys can DM me in my Instagram. I'm gonna put the link below. You guys could just go to that link afterwards after the video. I forgot to tell you guys to like, comment, and subscribe. Let me know how you guys feel about this video. As you can see, I'm putting glue on my eyelashes. I already trimmed the eyelashes and made sure that they fit my eyelid. I just had to clean up the glue because I put too much glue. And, you know, I'm a pro, so I don't need no mirror really to or no tweezer to put on my eyelash. Like, that's just me. I feel like this is more easier. I just look straight in the mirror and I do it. And then you're basically just gonna try to align the eyelash line on top of your real eyelashes, because it has to look as seamless as possible. The goal is to make it look like it's your eyelashes, but people know that it's not really eyelashes. And then you're just gonna squeeze them together with your fingers, as you can see. Now I'm using the Too Faced Lip Injection Lip Gloss in Extreme. I love this lip gloss. Even though it be burning my lips, it really plumps my lips. Y'all know I don't got no lips. Then I'm going back with the NARS Pure Radiant Tinted Moisturizer in the color Santiago. And I'm just gonna be spreading that around my face. Patting that around my face with a foundation brush, just making sure it gets everywhere. You gotta make sure that your neck match with your face, right? Not too much down your neck, but it gotta look seamless. Then I'm just using a wet beauty blender to blend in the foundation into my skin to make it look even more natural. Then I will be using another shade of the LA Girl Pro Concealer in the color, I believe it was, I don't remember, but it'll be down below in the comments, I mean in the links. But what I'm gonna do is put that on my bridge of my nose, under my eyes, in the center of my forehead, on my upper lip, sides of my lips, and my chin. Just all those sides, all those parts of your face that you want to highlight, that's where you want to put. And now I'm using another blending brush and what I'm going to do is pat out the outer portion of the concealer first. First of all, I like to let my concealer dry. I like to let my concealer dry because then it just comes out more seamless. Like, it just comes out less, like, mushy. It doesn't look like makeup. It looks like makeup, but people will know you have on makeup, but it'll just look neat. Like, you won't look, like, shiny and greasy. And just, your makeup won't look all blotchy. So we're gonna just be working from the outer corner in, and you're just gonna pat that concealer in until it's just to your liking. And we're gonna continue to do that I think the concealer that I was using was in, it wasn't an almond, that was for my eyebrows. But it had to be, it was in Cool Tan, that's what it was in. It was in Cool Tan. Yep. So now, as you guys can see, I'm just blending out the rest of my areas. It doesn't matter how much you blend out on your forehead, even though it'll spread. You're just gonna blend that out when you have to contour your face with the bronzer. I do not like to contour my nose with like make it skinny or anything, but like bronzer or anything, I feel like my nose is fine. I don't want to make myself look too different. What I'm using here for my setting powder, and I will put the link below, Sasha Cosmetics setting powder in the shade Buttercup. This setting powder is bomb. Only setting powder that I've been using for like the past 2 years. Princess Reese put me on, and you can only order this setting powder online. You can't buy it anywhere in stores. So the link will be below. And I'm just putting that everywhere where I put my concealer. And I put that on also on top of my eyelids, because that's where I put my concealer at too. Just so, because my eyelids are oily. So I put that there so it won't be oily. I don't know if you guys have oily eyelids. I have eyelids, but I hate that. Because then it makes the makeup like look bulky and just nasty. Now I'll be using the Anastasia bronzer, powder bronzer in the color Saddle. I'm just going to put this on the outer portion of my forehead and my under my cheekbones, just to structure, make my face look structured and more dark, and to even out, not more dark, but to even out the concealer that I put on my face, so my face is not too light. Then I'm just going to, as you can see, I'm blending all of that in with a beauty blender, so everything could just blend in together and look seamless, you know. Then I'll be using Morph setting spray, the continuous setting spray. I'm putting on more of my Too Faced lip injection, lip gloss, you know, my small lip gloss, get that. And that's it. I hope you guys like this. Don't forget to purchase my eyelashes. I will put the link below. And I'll put everything else below that I can use.